The number of Chinese transgressions into the Indian side of the line of actual control last year has shot up by almost 50%. Remember, this is the same year that the Indian and the Chinese were involved in the 73-day face-off at the Doklam on the Sikkim-Bhutan border. Let's take a closer look at these numbers. According to a report, there were 415 transgressions by Chinese soldiers into the Indian side of the LAC in 2017, as against 271 transgressions in 2016. The number of face-offs too have been high. The spike of 48% has been witnessed. The number stood at 216 in 2017, up from 146 in 2016. 23 major areas of dispute on the LAC have been identified by the Indian side, where most Chinese transgressions and face-offs occur. These include Demchok in Ladakh, Kaurik in Himachal Pradesh, and Barati in Uttarakhand, Dibang Valley in Arunachal Pradesh, among others. That being said, the 26th flag meeting between brigadier rank officers of the two armies have also been held since 2016. And on this issue, I'm joined by my colleague Ramesh Ramachandran. Ramesh, tell me, what is the reason behind the spiking up of the transgressions which have taken place in the line of actual control? Is it because, Ramesh, that the regime transformation took place, where the top leadership or the top leader of China was re-strengthened and restated?
Well, morning, Karthike. There's no definite pattern to the so-called Chinese transgressions across the line of control. Remember, I want to qualify this by saying there's no official confirmation about this data published by a section of the Indian media yet from the Ministry of Defense. But that said, if the report is anything to go by, the number of transgressions has increased in 2017 as compared to the previous year by almost 60 to 70%. Now, from India's perspective, the number of transgressions being more than the number of face-offs means that at many places, Chinese transgressions are going unchallenged. And that, to my mind, would be a big worry for the Indian Army. But that said, the transgressions along the line of control extend all the way from Jammu and Kashmir in the north to Arunachal Pradesh in the east. And one at the same time, it's not surprising because China can be expected to probe India at multiple locations along this undemarcated LAC. And Doklam is a good example of just that.
Ramesh, that's the point. Or is it also because of the fact that, by doing these incursions, you create a sort of a psychological instability. Nothing changes on the ground, but it just also goes on to show that something which matters to you doesn't matter to them that much.
Indeed, psychological ops or psyops, as they call it, plus the fact, Karthike, that China wants to unilaterally change the status quo obtaining at the line of actual control, and in the hope that tomorrow going forward it might be figuratively a fait accompli and that might be the demarcated border. But that said, India says this can only be discussed and determined by mutual talks, mutual dialogue at designated times and locations, and China should desist from making any unilateral changes to the status quo obtaining at the line of control today.
Thank you, Ramesh, for this update. So my colleague Ramesh Ramachandran was giving us that update and analyzing us for us as to why there has been a spike in the cross-border incursions.